What is going on, everybody? I hope you're all having an awesome day. Today, it's just starting to snow. This is going to be, hopefully, a pretty big snowstorm. I don't know if it's picking it up on this GoPro, but it's actually a really nice Colorado snow. But anyway, today's video is going to be about my car. This is going to be an overview on the options, the features, everything technically that is inside the car or outside the car. I got a comment from a viewer that wants to see some of the options that are on my car and the features like cruise control, air conditioning, that type of stuff. I'm pretty sure that standard on all these cars was cruise control, air conditioning, radio, that type of thing. These cars came pretty loaded from the manufacturers. So on my car in particular, I'm just going to cover what my car came with standard and what was options. So that may differ from car to car, but I'll go through and from what I know, I'll show you what's different. Primarily just on the outside, my car has the GT Sport Package is what they called it. So that gave you upgraded 19-inch rims, which look amazing on this car. Versus like the 18-inch wheels that you got on the regular G8s. There were some interior bits that were different, like the steering wheel. That was different. But I think suspension was just tuned a little bit more for sport on these with the sport package. I can't really remember that to be honest. But the biggest difference with the GT Sport Package was the upgraded wheels. The only thing I've changed on my car is the side marker lights. I have plasti-dipped black, and actually the light still shines through them, which is really awesome. I had some leftover plasti-dip and just decided to do it. All these cars come standard with halogen bulbs. They're not HIDs, they're just regular halogen style bulbs. Of course, you got fog lights. The lights on this car are really excellent. You get, on the GT cars, you do get two piston front rotors, two piston front calipers, nice big brakes. I think the stopping power is adequate for the car. It stops really good. Your fuel cap and door is on this side. I'm sorry about the exhaust if it's messing with the sound. Make sure you do tighten this 3 clicks. I didn't do that, and I actually had a check engine light come on, so definitely tighten that 3 clicks. But the door is on the passenger side. Takes a little bit of getting used to, but otherwise it works just fine. I have a Borla exhaust on my car, so that's why it's a bit deeper sound. And let's move on into the engine bay here. I'll pop the hood. On all these cars, the hood latch is right here. Just pull it. So my car has a Volant cold air intake, and it also has a Super Chips tune with the Borla catback. This was not done by me. I want to remove that this spring. It's just, I can't stand that. It's been there since I got the car. I got it used from the previous owner. This is for your coolant. You pop this off to check the level as well as put coolant in the system. Oil fill cap and your dipstick. This is the ABS module. Of course, you got your intake system. This is for your power steering fluid to check. This pops off and you can check the level. This is for your battery. Since the battery's in the back, this is where you jump start the car. Positive goes there, your negative can go there, and you can jump start the car. Now, if I'm wrong, please comment in the section below, but I think that's how you can jump start one of these. I haven't had to do it, but it does say right here on what to do. Here's your VIN tag right here that tells you everything about the car. Mine was made in October of 08. It has the FE2 suspension, as you can see right there. So that's a really important piece. This is how they look from the factory. If this is weird looking, I wouldn't purchase the car, but that's how they came from the factory. Of course, you got your windshield washer cap. This you never want to really remove. That's just more of a service cap for the radiator. Definitely don't touch that. Here is these hood vents actually are functional. So these right here line up with that, which is pretty awesome. So yeah, that is actually a functioning hood vent system. So that's pretty much all you need to know underneath the engine bay of one of these. This cover is painted. I painted that red myself. They come standard as silver. I just used some Rust-Oleum red to paint it. But that's pretty much it. Maintenance is real simple. Just check your oil over there from the dipstick and check your air filter. And every year or so, check your power steering fluid. But pretty much simple. Also, check your coolant. I do it every couple of months just to make sure it's all topped up and ready to go. To get to your cabin air filter, you just pop these off and it sits down in there to change it if you need to. Let's remove that. So yeah, let's move on to the interior portion. So on the G8s, the door handles have a really nice sound to them. They're very solid doors. They're just really high quality. The rear ones have the same sort of, they're just a really high quality door, in my opinion. The G8 that I have has the black Onyx leather package. I think that was also part of the GT Sport package, but it gets you leather on your door panel here. That's pretty much standard throughout the G8s unless they have cloth seating. Really nice padded armrests. This has the Blaupunkt sound system. So you have speakers in the doors. All four doors have speakers. There's two tweeters in the dash, as well as two subwoofers factory from the rear behind the headrests. Here's the leather. The leather is kind of rough. It's not the softest leather, but it's really durable. Most of the G8s with the leather will stretch right here, so you're not going to get away from that. Mine does it. A lot of the G8s I've seen with the leather, they do stretch right here, so they get like this little divot right here. The steering wheel on this car is from the GT Sport package. Includes this really nice steering wheel. It's almost like a flat bottom design. I'll show you that more when we get inside. So yeah, that's pretty much it here on the doors. I'm gonna go ahead and hop on in, get it in where it's warm. So for the interior portion of this, the steering wheel, let's just get right into that. It's almost like a flat bottom style. It's slightly rounded, but it has really good positions here for your thumbs. Very nice leather. I just can't say enough good things about this wheel. The only downside is it's rather big. It's not small like, let's say, a Mitsubishi Evo steering wheel. This is a pretty good sized steering wheel. But otherwise, very nice, very high quality, and it's wearing really nice. I usually put my thumb right here. This is how I drive, and there's no wear marks on either side. So that's really just really awesome. There isn't any wear marks. I do treat this with a leather conditioner every now and then, but pretty much that is the way it looks. So the GT Sport package includes your wheels, I think a different tuning on the suspension and the steering wheel, and different little trims like a leather on your shifter here. So for the gauges on this car, they're very simple. I really do love the way they look. I'm gonna be using this button right here. You push down, so it changes your screen right here. So you got different like units you can change. Your TPMS sensors, don't freak out. I haven't adjusted my sensors yet. I haven't reset them. So my far right ones are the front, and the far left are my are the rear tires. But it tells you your tire pressures and stuff. Different options. There's the odometer, 34,765. Your range. I've been idling. I haven't been driving this car because the road's been pretty bad. So I've been just starting it up and letting it idle and revving it a few times. So that's why the MPG's down. Let's go back to that. The overspeed function, I don't ever use. But if you see, I can't zoom in, I'm on a GoPro, but it's overspeed. You can set it to like 70 miles an hour, and once you go over that, the thing will chime saying, hey, you're over your speed. But otherwise, a very nice gauge layout. You got your temperature, RPM, and your speedometer over there with your gas gauge over there. On this side, you have your lighting controls. I usually just leave it on auto, but you have your parking sensors and, your parking lights. And full on. If you pull out, it clicks on your fog lights, and if you push in, turns them off. So I just put them on auto. Auto works great, and you can manually turn them off by turning the switch this way. This is your dimmer for your dash lights. Dim them, you can dim them or you can turn them up. I usually leave about halfway through. They're pretty bright, so you can usually light the cabin up pretty well with just the dash lights with that. Cruise control was standard in all the G8s. This is your blinker stalk. To turn cruise control on, you hit the button. I'll hit the button for you to show what it does. It says cruise on. So you can just turn your cruise control on that way. Of course, I'm trying to get it better. Here, we'll do that. You can, set is down, resume is up, and you can also increase and decrease speed with this by just rotating it up or down, which is really nice. Really handy feature on the interstate because you can just place your hand right here and then just toggle them up and down. Buttons from the steering wheel. This is for your radio. It will, if I show you here, if I move this up or down, this little wheel, it moves the different channels on the presets, as you see there. So that's a very nice feature. You can go through and move your presets around. Volume control for the radio. Again, same little switch. You move it up or move it down. This is for the OnStar phone. This is not for Bluetooth. 2009 and a half came with Bluetooth, but they also came with slightly less power. So if you see down here, I don't have anywhere that says a Bluetooth logo. They'd usually say like Bluetooth in here or something like that. If it says Bluetooth anywhere on the inside of the G8, it's a 2009 and a half, and they were down about 10 horsepower from the 2008 and 2009 cars because it increased emissions. They had two sets of catalytic converters instead of just one. So that's a bit of a disappointment, but this is just for the OnStar phone, which is OnStar phone. I don't use that because nobody who uses OnStar anymore. I'll turn my fan down so you can hear me a little bit better. Passenger airbag off. Got a compass up here. So it's also, you know, auto dimming. Of course, horn, pretty much standard stuff there. The biggest thing I love about this dash is the digital speedometer. That is a great feature. You can go and easy to read, and it's very accurate. Also, it'll show your radio information up top there. And down below is for your transmission, shows which gear you're in. Let's move down to the radio head unit area down here. 2008 cars, they actually had a screen in here that had, usually I think it had battery voltage and oil, the oil pressure or something like that was up here. 2009 cars like mine don't have that. I think it's because the 2008 cars got complaints about how it was almost like an Atari game sort of deal. So they call it the Atari gauges, but you actually can buy gauges to fit in these little, in this little cubby here. And you can actually get a whole new dash piece to put big like boost gauges and stuff if you're heavily modified. So down here on the center stack, this is the Blaupunkt audio system. Some G8s came with a bass stereo. I have never actually seen a G8 with a bass stereo. I think they're rather rare to find one. So a bass stereo, you wouldn't have this screen. It would look like a radio out of like a Chevy Cobalt or something. And you wouldn't get the nice speakers. But I'm very hard pressed to find one that actually doesn't have this setup here. But the Blaupunkt system is a very nice system. I think it's a very clear system. I think it's like 250 watts of power. So not the highest powered stereo, but it's a very clear sounding stereo. So you have a load of buttons here, which when the car came out, it got a little bit of crap for basically being too confusing. I'll get to that in a little bit, but basically all you need to know is that's for your clock. That changes it to tell you what time and date it is. Very handy feature. That's nice. You have an information button here. If you push this will tell you what each button does basically. Press any buttons for detail, and press help button to go back. So that's a nice feature if you're unfamiliar. So they can help you tell what each button does. This button here, it changes it just to regular FM or ASM. I haven't really, you can do like FM 1 or FM 2 on that. I just leave it on that because that's where all my presets are at. Equalizer, I don't use this. I set my own tone settings, but you can go through and set like rock or country or that type of stuff is pretty normal for your equalizer switch. You got your preset radio stations down here. On this side's a power button to turn the system off or turn it on, and it'll show the Pontiac logo, which is really nice. Down here is for your CD. Your play and pause is actually through here. Band, this will switch it to AM or XM satellite radio. I actually don't have XM satellite radio connected in the car, and in my opinion it sounds a little muted, so I have that disconnected, but it is still nice to have the XM radio stuff set up. I just go FM. This is for a rear auxiliary. So on the back of this head unit, there's actually an auxiliary input that you can put in for like a DVD player. Some people actually run videos off of these if you want to tear apart your dash. I haven't touched that, so that's what that's for. Moving down here, this is your volume knob. As you can see, it brings your volume up. This here does not actually tune your radio, which is funny. You think it would, but as you can see, I'm spinning it and it's not doing anything. This is actually for your menu control. So if you push in on the button, it brings up different menu settings, like on audio, time and date. If you go to audio, you can set everything up to wait the way you want it. Time and date setup, you know, that type of thing. You set your time through there. So this is solely for your menu control, nothing else. So if you want to actually change the radio station individually, like a normal dial would, you actually have to hit this button here. And if you watch, see how I'm pushing it, it's actually moving the station up, which is very confusing. My dad actually has trouble with this. He'll get in and start turning this to change the channel, and he's like, why is it not doing it? You have to hit this down here. Takes a little bit of getting used to, but that's one of the main confusing things for these, because this says disc and track. You don't even think it's for the normal FM radio. And same thing down here, you can seek, and it'll search the station for you. So that's just a little thing to have to get used to on these systems, but otherwise a very clear sounding system, and I really enjoy it. Down here, you got rear defrost, exterior temperature, front defrost, recirculate, fan control, your zone control up here. Over here, you have your air conditioning and power on and off. And right here is actually for your second zone. So if I turn this, see how it says H, and I can actually individually adjust the other zone. That was actually, if you hit this button here, zone, it'll bring it back to your controlling the whole thing. Of course, you have auto as well. This system here, this whole system right here, I think was an option. Most G8s come with them. That you're going to find most G8 GTs will come with them. Even the cloth interiored G8s will come with this system. But that was pretty much standard throughout. Some of the base cars, some of the press cars when the car was out, had a different head unit that did not have the dual zone. But that's pretty much standard. Heated seats were an option. My car is fitted with the heated seats. Here's your traction control button, is right here. Push it once and it turns everything off. I mean everything. Traction control, stability control, you push it once, everything goes off. There's no holding it, there's no tapping it three times, everything is off. And push it once again to turn everything on. And that works like you wouldn't believe. It definitely turns everything off. Here's your gear selector down here. So basically, you press in, you know, standard stuff. Puts it into drive, as it says up there. There's a sport mode for this, and how you activate that is you push it over, and it'll say sport shift on the dash. And then if you want to go into manual mode, you just pull back on one of these, and it'll say manual mode is selected. You can push forward or pull back, whichever way you want to go, and it'll activate your manual mode. So that's a nice thing to have. It works really good, I think. The Super Chips tune that I have on this has a transmission tune, and it really livened up how this thing shifts. So that's a really nice feature. Moving down to here, you do have kind of this, your window controls are here, which is a really strange thing to get used to, because usually they're on the doors. But I actually prefer it now down here. After owning this car for like 3 years, I think, 3.5 years, I can just rest my hand, especially in the summertime, I'm rolling my windows up and down. I can just rest here with my hand, and it will go through, and I can roll my window up or down, and not have to move my hand instead of having to go over here. I guess because I'm right-handed, that's why this feels better. Of course, you have your mirror controls here, and your lock and unlock. All G8s had this. This is not standard. Mine does have automatic down driver's side window. I don't know if that was standard on the base models, but this is pretty much what you're going to find throughout. Of course, you got cup holders, your glove box here. Pretty good size. I can fit a lot in there. One goofy thing is inside the glove box, here's your trunk button, okay? So to open your trunk is in there. So yeah, that's just one funny thing about the G8 is the trunk opening switch is in there. Let me see, what else have I forgot? Oh yeah, wiper controls are over here. Typical wiper stuff, you open it, you know, different settings there. There's a little selector here to do your intermittent speed. I usually just set it at 1. Doesn't really rain here too much, and I usually don't drive this in the rain. You push down and release, which it does by itself. That is for your mist. So you got wiper controls there. And if you pull back on the stock, it will clean your windshield off with the windshield wiper fluid. That's pretty much it. Oh yeah, the keys. I'll show you the keys that you get. So I got with my car, I got a flip key. I think these are standard throughout the G8 line, no matter if you got V6 base, GT base. You have a flip key here. Of course, you push the little button here to bring it up, which is really nice. Remote start on these, I think, was standard on the V8 cars. So basically what you do is you lock, like right here, until the horn sounds, and then you hold down this little button here until the engine starts, and then release. So it looks something like this. So yeah, that's a pretty cool little key there. You also get, if I can find it in my pocket here, I like to call the valet key. It's a standard key without a flip-up thing, which is really awesome. It has all the same features, trunk, remote start, same sort of deal, but it is just the key to give to the valet. That's why it's kind of plain Jane looking. So yeah, that's a really nice thing they do for you, is they give you 2 sets of keys. That's what my car came with. You also have your e-brake down here, and you have a little cubby hole. And what's funny, since this car is also made in Australia and sold in Europe, right-hand drive is very popular. So I think what they did here is they made the center console able to switch between putting this over here and this over here. So I bet you in Australia, I think it is, the e-brake's over here and this little cubby's over here. So that's kind of a cool little thing they do. It kind of lets you know you're in something a little bit special. Up here, where normally you'd have a sunroof, I don't have that. That's the only option I am missing on my car. You have lighting control here. So there's actually no light switches in the back. You have to hit this button here, and it'll turn on the lighting for both the front and the rear, which is kind of a little quirk, but I like it. It works okay. Now, this is for your door when you open your door, if you want lights on or off. Of course, you got your standard little thing here. So most of this inside my car is standard. Of course, like dual zone and the Blaupunkt was an option. You'll be hard pressed to find a G8 without all this. I haven't actually seen one, so I think what you'll find sometimes more common is cloth seats with this system, or leather seats without the sport package, which doesn't get you this awesome steering wheel. You'll see more of a round steering wheel instead of this more chunkier one. So I think those are the 2 biggest things. Oh yeah, this I did myself. It's 3M carbon fiber wrap. I think I would leave off the 6-liter L76 badge, but I did it because I was younger and I thought it was cool, but I think I'd leave that off in the future. But it got rid of, there was silver trim, sort of like this right here, that was on the dash, and I thought this gave it a much cleaner, nicer look, made it blend in. Plus, it kind of looks like carbon fiber. I know it isn't, but I quite like the way it looks. So yeah, let's hop in the back and I'll show you what that's like. So here's the rear door for the G8. Same great quality feel to it. Of course, you got your leather door handle. There is window switches for the passengers. Storage down here. Storage in this car is really good. Each door has their own little pocket with a water bottle holder. But the seats are really awesome. You can see the carbon fiber, the rear subwoofer back behind the headrest back there. I'm going to hop in and shut the door so that way snow doesn't get in. So with this car, there is tons and tons of room back here. I have the front seat in my driving position. I'm about 6'1", and there's just so much room back here. I mean, I can move my leg and not even hit anything. That seat's all the way back, and you can see that there is just tons of room back here. These rear seats are super comfortable. Of course, the features you get back here are a little tiny armrest, which is really nice and squishy. Works really nice. Now, there's no cup holders in that, but what's really funny is if you push down on this button here, okay, whoops, hit the camera there, here comes out this big old thing, and this is where your cup holders are, but it leads into the trunk, which I think is a really funny thing. It's like a trunk pass-through / cup holders, but there's your cup holders. This whole big thing lays down. You can fit like a laptop here if you wanted to. It's just really funny that they did that, but that's what it is on the G8s. Of course, you push it back and it slams shut. Here's your other subwoofer. There's speakers over there. Window controls the same. Air vents back here, and there's a little cubby hole down there for people to put their stuff. Back seats are just really roomy. The leather's the same, but the headrests are just super, super squishy. Of course, you do have a rear lighting back here, and you also have a little thing right here. So overall, just a really awesome back seat. Lots of room, very practical. Of course, you have little mat pocket things. But just really awesome. I'm really impressed with the back seat. I think you also have child safety lock things, that type of stuff. Just a ton of headroom too. Of course, you can see my ridiculous hat, but I got plenty of headroom back here, and I'm not even sitting right, so got plenty of headroom. So pretty awesome little back seat. I'll show you the trunk, which I need to undo. I'll grab a key here. Bear with me. Grab the key. And let's show you the trunk, and then we'll finish the video up. So here's on the key to open the trunk. You just hold it down. Of course, the trunk on these are really big. You got all sorts of room that you could ever want. These are two big car covers, and I have them back here. I can't even get all my hands back in there, but there's plenty of room back here. Here's your battery. It's right there behind this little shield. Mine did come with a net to put cargo in. We got some junk in here from the road trip I did, but otherwise just a really awesome little trunk, or big trunk back here. So anyway, that, oh yeah, again, I don't know what the deal was with the previous owner is chrome badges, but I'm getting rid of that. that's from a V8 from like a Ford or something. I don't know. That'll be coming off too. But anyway, that is the overview and features overview and options of the car. I think I covered just about everything that you can get on one of these. My car, again, has every option except a sunroof. So it may vary between G8s. But definitely check out the G8s. If they have the Blaupunkt system, they pretty much have every option, probably lacking leather or the sport package or both like mine. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Definitely check out the rest of the channel. I'm sorry about how long this is. Probably my longest videos in a while. But definitely check out the rest of the channel. Hit that subscribe button and the like button, and I will see you all in the next video. So thanks for watching, guys, and take it easy.